Hello everyone, medical scribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. In the previous video, we explained an introduction about the axial skeletal system, in which we understood the general meaning of this system. Then we took a look at the main important functions of the axial skeletal system. And as you know, we say that the axial bones will be distributed over many regions. So today, our topic will be about the skull bones, which is the first region in the axial skeleton. First of all, we should understand that the skull is the structure that forms a cavity which will contain the brain. This skull will be composed of 22 bones fused together, except the mandible, which will still mobile. So we conclude that we have 21 bones fused together, and one mobile bone, which is the mandible. Well, those 21 bones in infant will also be separated. That means they aren't fused yet. This separation is extremely important in infants in order to facilitate the delivery and the head exiting from the mother. And also, there will be a space for the brain to grow comfortably. But when this baby gets older, these separated bones will fuse together as we knew in order to give the strength to protect the brain from any danger. And if we need to be more precise in the skull bones, we will find that these bones will be classified according to their locations into the bones that found in the superior portion of the brain, which called the cranial bones, and into the bones that found into the anterior and inferior portion of the skull, which called the facial bones. So, regarding the cranial bone, they are 8 blade-shaped bones that will form the cranial cavity, which is the bulk of the skull. These 8 bones are 2 parietal bones, one on each side of the skull, 2 temporals, one frontal, one occipital, one ethmoid, and one sphenoid. Those are 8 bones. Well, the function of these bones, or the function of the cranial bones, is they will protect the brain, which is a very critical issue for the human. And also, they will provide an attachment point for the muscles of the head and neck. So these are the cranial bones. While regarding the facial bones, they are 14 bones. These bones are 2 bones for each of the maxillae, the zygomatic, the palatine, the lacrimals, and the inferior nasal concha, while one bone for the vomer and one for the mandible. These are the facial bones. Well, the functions of these bones are also important, in which the first one is they will make up the face, and also they will form and protect the entrance of the respiratory and the digestive tracts, while the third function, they will provide cavities for the sense organs, which are the eyes, the mouth, and the nose. While the last function is they will provide an attachment point for the facial muscles. So these were almost all important details and a brief explanation about the skull bones, which is the first region in the axial skeletal system. And that's it. I hope that I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.